What we said a couple of years ago is that you really can't look at what's called, you know, the daily ratings that we get, that's the live plus same day, as indicative. Now, it's a little complicated. Here's the story. We get paid for 3 days. In other words, we get paid for people who watch a program, and notably the commercials, for the main day of broadcast, the second day, and the third day. After that, we don't get paid anymore, but we still get ratings for the fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh day. In other words, what Nielsen does is they measure a program across 7 days. And the reason that it's important from an evaluation standpoint to look at the live 7 rating is because that does tell you the magnitude of the audience. And again, it tells you, I mean, a show like The Office can, you know, have a rating in the threes for its live rating, but it can end in the fives, which it does because of time shifting. And so if you're evaluating the popularity of a program from a program standpoint, you really have to look at Live 7 because that's the way people consume TV these days. I mean, overnight ratings are difficult, and honestly, it would be great if they went away. But TV executives need their daily fix, and they need it early, and nobody wants to wait. And so that's one of the problems. So I think we'll always have some indicator of how a program did, but before anybody, you know, either breaks open the champagne or jumps out the window, you need to wait a little bit of time to see what's going on. If you rank order the shows, and this comes from Nielsen, you know, for NBC, The Office is the most time shifted, 44%, Community also 44%, but in that range, ABC's Modern Family, you know, CBS's Big Bang Theory, you know, Grey's Anatomy, Gossip Girl. So, I mean, you know, it's a pretty broad range. It has to be a show people really like, and you can see the shows that I mentioned were shows that, you know, have a pretty good... And also, it tends to be shows that are in competitive environments, like Thursday Night's pretty competitive. And the obverse is true. We know what shows aren't time-shifted. For example, if they are time-shifted, they're played back very quickly. The most obvious one are ones where there's a spoiler factor. So, you know, people don't want to time-shift or wait and store on their DVR, you know, the result of a reality, you know, show. Or if people are going to be talking about the show, a big water cooler show, they want to be able to come in the next day and talk about it. So, you know, we do have some sense about what shows are more likely to be time shifted than others.